Parents of bullies, when did you realize your child was a bully and how did you react? My sister, who I partially raised, was a bully, and one of my long-term foster kids was definitely a bully in the beginning, not to be cliche, but it was nearly entirely due to trauma and mental health problems. My sister turned out to have some pretty serious bipolar. My foster son had been abused in every sense, actively isolated, and had gone to 5 schools by the 3rd grade. Gone is in quotes because he never actually went. Both of them were very obviously bullies in different ways. My sister was manipulative and was constantly lying to get her way. My foster son also lied a lot but was not very good at it, and mostly had physical aggression. I worked with my foster son and his therapists a lot to navigate situations with bullying. He started on his own saying things like, "Hey, I'm sorry I was rough back there," or "It makes me scared when I think someone is going to hit me in the head." The kids were super forgiving, and I honestly think the hardest part for him, once he got less defensive, was forgiving himself. He also saw me defend him with other adults and kids a few times, so he learned the difference between standing up for yourself and being malicious. Some kids are just being dicks, but some of them really have been through it and are acting out because of it. In preschool, my daughter began to show signs of being a mean girl. She would talk about refusing to play with someone because she didn't like their clothes and convince her friends not to play with other kids. I watched the edited for TV version of Mean Girls with her, and we stopped and talked about how the kids treated each other and how they might be feeling. She started being nicer all around. What really spoke to her was being the victim of a mean girl situation in first grade. Now in middle school, she is quick to identify mean girls and bullies, doesn't let herself become their victims, and befriends kids who are victims and helps them connect with other nice kids. The biggest bully that went after me at school, with all the names, pushing, pranks, etc. His mother worked for the school, so I told her, "Your son is a real ass." A year after I graduated high school, the meanest, most popular girl in school mother called my mom and said, "I'm sorry if my daughter ever upset or hurt your daughter." Apparently, she called a bunch of girls' moms from my grade to apologize for her daughter's behavior. My son is 4 and has started some bullying behavior. He will call other kids stupid just out of the blue, or talk openly about how much cooler, better his choice is than some other kids. His mom and I pretty much nip it in the bud right there. We tell him that saying things like that is not cool, and we have him go up to the kid, apologize, and then compliment them. I really hope that this is just a phase. Was told my kid was a bully in 4th grade. Okay, I had seen signs of him being bossy to his sisters, so we had numerous talks. I watched him like a hawk, jumped on him if he even so much as gave a sideways glance at his sisters. Later on, the kid he supposedly bullied came to a small gathering at our house. What a little shit that kid was. Took our digital camera off my husband's desk when they were expensive items and broke the battery compartment hinge because he threw the stupid camera because it wasn't Polaroid. I had a hard time keeping my husband from bullying this little shit. Later still, talking to other parents, my son was not the only unfairly accused. The little shit was tiny for his age, had red hair and freckles and long eyelashes and a sweet smile, and at first glance was angelic. My son was cool with our temporary mistrust, because it came out he was not the only one. I always wonder what became of the little shit. When I had to change my work schedule to pick my kids up from school because my second grader was verbally antagonizing a 7/8 grader on the walk home, it started with her complaining she was being bullied till her older brother told on her that she was instigating. Long story short, it was her way of trying to get more attention from me because she didn't have the words to explain what she wanted. It happened years ago, a bit after I went from being a stay-at-home mom to a single working mom. I've made more effort to spend more time with them. Not a parent, but my older brother was a horrendous bully to both myself and other children. He was just abnormally aggressive from day one. First thing he did when I was born was try to attack me, and from there began years of physical attacks that would last into my teens. And when he began school, it wasn't long before he started attacking and bullying other kids too. He was also a poor student and was always getting into other sorts of trouble, etc. He really relished violence, arguing and being antisocial. My parents were split on the issue of my brother's antisocial behavior. No matter what my brother did wrong, he was my mother's golden boy, but at the same time, she expected my father to discipline my brother while she refused to intervene and made constant excuses for his behavior. Then one day my father died, and after that, there was nobody with either the power, will to properly intervene on my brother's bad behavior. So the downward spiral of endless incidents at different schools continued and eventually culminated in my brother getting expelled with no grades. He was not unloved. Over the years, endless relatives, friends and teachers etc. doted on him and gave him so many opportunities, educational and otherwise. People were always convinced that there must be some sort of understandable reason for why he was the way he was, and that all he needed was the right sort of support and he would improve. These days he openly identifies himself as a psychopath. And you know, I would have to agree somewhat with that self-diagnosis. He is very smart, but he seems to suffer from a profound lack of innate ability to empathize with other people. Despite this though, he views himself as a superior being and he has a long history of manipulative behavior. I can't say that things worked out great for my brother. As an adult in his 30s, he is a fascist with very few friends. No real career, no education. He has wasted a lot of his inheritance and he has alienated almost every person in my family because of reputations he developed for being lazy, antisocial, undependable, manipulative, hard to handle and just generally lacking in integrity. I myself cut him out of my life because he was nothing but drama and because he also remained very volatile and threatening even as an adult. Overall, while my mother's approach to raising my brother certainly didn't help things, I also think that there was something fundamentally wrong with my brother from the get-go. Skeptical smiley face. A kid beat me up in first grade once and he got suspended. I was afraid of looking like a wimp with my black eye and busted lips, so the school pet me take time off until the bruise went down and my lip swelling went down, and told the other kids I bumped my head pretty hard and needed to rest. When I came back, I was called to the office in the morning and the kid was in there with his mom. Holy shit, was that woman scary when she's mad. The principal said op, insert dude who whooped my ass's name, would like to day something. He just stood there for like 5 minutes until his mom broke the silence with, hey, quit being an ass and say it, while smacking him not hard, just enough to let him know that she meant business upside the back of the head, to which he apologized. His mom told him to get his ass to the car while she talked to me. After her rage subsided, she was the sweetest woman ever. She said her elder sons bullied him and she thinks he was looking to take that out on someone smaller than me, and that she should have done something about it and that she was more sorry than he is. After that she have me some chocolate and other candy and said, don't worry, if he so much as acts up one more time she will paint his back porch red, as well as her older sons for bullying her youngest so much. Pretty good friends with the guy now. Really mild-mannered dude. His mom is also hot, even after over 10 years. The first week of first grade, the teacher told us he was starting to have bully-like behavior. We've struggled with counteracting it since, and he's 13 now, but he also is autistic with a learning delay and has a lot of issues, either being super focused on something, usually the wrong thing, or nothing at all. It is always someone else. Someone else started it, or she was looking at me the wrong way. He will always have just one person he hates like a mortal enemy. You try to defuse the situation by telling him to tell the teachers when something happens so they can be aware of the situation, but it seems to be two-sided, always. Since starting high school this year, 2 terms, and we've been suspended twice. In primary school, he hit a kid in the face because she didn't blink. He thought she was a doll apparently. Honestly, as parents, we're doing our best. He is a very difficult child at the best of times and has only recently started medication for ADHD, which has helped his behavior significantly. But we still have to deal with the lesser understanding of consequences. Sometimes you just need to be lucky and have that breakthrough moment. I used to teach a kid with ADHD. In the class, one would give all the kids a small treat at the end for good behavior, and if he ever lost his, he would spiral down a path of tantruming and endless give me one more chance mantras, only solved by a parent coming to pick him up early. But one day I remembered that he really liked talking about Minecraft incessantly, so I tried using a Minecraft analogy. Jason, you know how in Minecraft that if you fall into the lava you lose all your diamonds? Treats in our class are like that. And right now you're getting really close to falling into the lava. He looked startled and immediately calmed down. And every class after that, all I had to say was, Jason, you need to be nicer. You're getting close to losing your diamonds in the lava. And he'd back off. Now obviously you know your kid better and what works for him. I only tell that story as a suggestion if you haven't already tried something like that. Sometimes you can use their obsessions. Dot and others times you can't. All you can keep doing is your best. Op, I know it's frustrating and you have my empathy, but you're trying. I remember this one kid who kept trying to pick fights with everyone had parents that was in charge of a local church. Parents got upset and tried to start a legal battle when I defended myself on the playground. I was suspended and my punishment was the new Spider-Man movie. It's pizza time. This is one of my biggest fears as a parent. Because for a long time my son was getting in trouble for hitting other kids randomly. This was in kindergarten. He's going into second grade now. Legit randomly. We had proof and everything. Like once he was putting his snow boots on and a kid was walking by. And my son, straight face and everything, stood up and just cold clocked this poor kid before calmly sitting back down and finishing getting his boots on. I started telling him if he was going to treat others that way, that's how he should be treated, because we follow the golden rule in our house. He didn't like that idea, and his behavior started to improve. For clarity, we didn't actually do anything to him. Just told him we would if he kept it up, and that he wouldn't have any friends because nobody wants to be friends with a bully. He still acts out sometimes, but it's gotten a lot better with talking about why something he did was wrong and how it makes others feel, and asking him how he would feel if someone did those things to him. Not me, but when I was growing up we had a neighbor kid who was like 6 years older than me, always teasing and making fun of me, until one day, when I was already in a shitty mood I was like six. It happened a lot. I put on my gloves, it was cold outside. Don't judge me, then jumped the fence and punched him square in the mouth, knocked one of his teeth out, and gave him a busted lip, went bawling inside. His mum came over an hour or so later and was basically like, yeah, I always knew he was a little shit. He deserved it. Then left. He never spoke to me again. Though, as far as I know, he's married now with his own kids. Not a parent. But I'm the eldest cousin and one of the younger lads had a bit of a bully phase when I was in my early teens. I was used to him picking on his little brother, but he started extending it to other lads, extended family and friends. He was tall for his age, so he abused that. But I was bigger back then. I'm now a puny 5'9 to those 6 plus monstrosities. So I put him in a headlock and asked how it felt. He started crying. He cut his shit after that. At least around me. He still picks on his brother as an adult. But if anyone else tries, he unleashes holy wrath. Hopefully I wasn't a bully. I didn't pick on people, but if people picked on me I was like, right. My niece has been going through the mean toddler phase for about 2 years, whereby she actively seeks out younger, smaller children, chiefly her cousin, my daughter, and physically dominates them. She is possessive over anything and everything and generally makes other kids' lives hell. My SIL is absolutely useless at disciplining her, whereas her dad is too much, so she gets very mixed signals in what's right and what's wrong. My solution has been that when she is a bully towards my kids or others that I am around, I will watch her like a hawk, and once she has had her first strike there are no more chances. I isolate my kids from her and have them play nicely and put her on a sort of forced playtime timeout where she isn't allowed to play with us, and then tell her it is because she was mean to another child. I am the stepmother of a bully. It isn't significant other's firstborn son. We only get to see him once a week and it is horrible. He is always getting suspended from school for hitting kids, cussing out the teacher, and his bio mother does absolutely nothing. His bio father and I are not allowed to discipline him in any way, and he takes advantage of it. He has no remorse or empathy. He has tripped his 3-year-old brother on purpose just cause, tells his sister to shut up, calls her names and hits her just because. He once smacked a girl he was playing with so hard in the face she had a welt because she tagged him. and then looked us in the eyes and lied about it. I usually tell him to knock it off and ask him if he would like it if someone treated him that way. He doesn't care. In fact, he gets angry if I ask him that. I am honestly terrified that he will end up in prison. I no longer allow him around my son for fear he will hurt him. I know there is something wrong with this boy, but his mother is unwilling to discipline him in any way, and there is nothing we can do. Victim of one when I was young and heard what the parent did. I left school one day and the bully and his friends caught up with me, beat me up and threw me in the mud, then ran off with my cap. I cried on my way home, but before I got home, the father of one of the bullies caught up with me, gripping me strongly and held me hard against a stone wall, saying that I had stolen the bully's cap. The father was very angry and wouldn't relent. While I just cried more, he went through my bag and didn't find anything, then angrily shouted at me for throwing it away. It was clear that he wanted to drag me along to search for it, but I just gave up and went limp. Didn't move at all, and he just left me there by the road to cry. Later that day, my father went to talk to the bully's father. I don't know what specifics they talked about, but my father said that the bully's father just told the bully not to do it again, and that was it. Some parents can be assholes, even mine. When I heard of my son scaring another child at the bus stop, I marched him over to the child's house, lectured him how this was the wrong thing to do along the way, made him apologize to the other child and the parent, told him in front of them this was unacceptable and I would not tolerate it,